Reverend Father Anthony Ruckel, the president of this August gathering, the chief guest and the inaugurant of this day, Professor Richard Hay, Member of Parliament, Reverend Father Martin Adikagath, Director, ESSS, Archdiocese of Rapidly, Dr. Sadanandan, Vice Principal, St. Albert's College, Dr. T.A. Matthews, the Head Department of Commerce and Research Center, and my beloved and esteemed members of this international seminar on Rebuild Kerala in a Sustainable Manner. In August 2018, the state of Kerala experienced the most disastrous flood in this century. We have a memory of such a flood situation in the year 1924. After almost 96 years, after 1924, a more severe flood due to many reasons, especially due to the heavy rains we experienced. The flood unleashed large-scale damage to life and loss to the life, property, including human casualties, up to 370 numbers. It was rampant and caused damage to nearly 12 districts out of 14 districts in Kerala. The result was 1.3 million people in Kerala affected, incurring a fiscal loss of nearly 30,000 crores according to the recent estimations. The most encouraging and inspiring fact about this flood is nothing but the courage and bravery shown by the Keralites to fight this situation. In fact, we the Keralites did not behave like the flood-affected victims. Instead, they created an atmosphere of fraternity, elegant citizenship, and statesmanship. That is the unique aspect about this flood situation. Of course, we have demonstrated a clear sense of social solidarity. The people tried to own each other, individuals by individuals, family by family. Nearly 8.9 lakhs of people were in the relief camps. And every household not affected by the flood was actually hosting a lot of flood-affected people, working merely as a relief camps. Now the flood becomes a situation to strengthen our democracy and governance. It is an opportunity to reconnect with the environment, our culture and livelihood. It was a lesson for all of us. We have to learn so many things from this lesson. If not, the disasters will be repeated. Now, at this juncture, in this fine morning, we have gathered here to deliberate about the different aspects of this flood situation. Of course, all realms of the social sector has been affected by this flood. It may take decades to bring back the situation into normalcy. Families affected, states' infrastructure, agriculture, or sectors were severely affected. Now, we have a group of experts here who will be delivering on the different aspects of this post-flood scenario. Today, we have three plenary sessions where about 20 topics will be presented by the experts in the corresponding fields. And outcome of this seminar, we expect maybe the compilation of more practical solutions in the different sectors to rebuild the sectors in a sustainable manner. Sometimes it will enable us to formulate strategies to design more nature-friendly projects, and also the coordination of the different departments for the purpose of rebuild Kerala in a sustainable manner. With this, I am entering my duty of welcoming the hard people who are gathered here today. First of all, the president of this gathering, Reverend Father Anthony Arakel, is the chairman and manager of St. Albert's College. He is a strong pillar of St. Albert's College, giving us all guidance and support. On behalf of everybody gathered here, I welcome you, Father, as the president of this gathering. His Excellency, Right Reverend Dr. Joseph Carrigi, said he was about to come, but due to some unexpected reasons, he could not turn up. Here, we have with us Professor Richard Hay, a familiar face to Keralites, representing the Anglo-Indian community of India in the Parliament. He is known as a writer and also a very strong teacher. He has written a book on the professional ethics of teachers, and also he is an environment-friendly man, because I noted that he is instrumental in the establishment of World Wildlife Fund in Kerala, and also he is well connected to the Zoological Society in so many ways. He is connected to the nature. I invite Professor Richard Hay as an inaugurant of this esteemed gathering. Reverend Father Martin Adikagat, presently serving as the director of ESSS, Archdiocese of Veraguli. I feel that he is a man capable of converting our idea and suggestions and proposals into the reality, who is able to mobilize the people, and of course he will be able to do so many projects in order to save the people from this tragic situation. On behalf of everybody gathered here, I welcome you, Father, to this gathering. I welcome Dr. Sadanandan, the Vice Principal of this college, and also Dr. T.A. Matthews. I must say that the Department of Commerce, St. Albert's College, Postgraduate Research Department of Commerce, took the initiative to convene this program. They were working in a very dedicated manner, and they were after this program for the last 1 week, and this is the culmination of this, their efforts. So I congratulate them, and also I welcome Dr. Tia to this gathering. In fact, I know that people sitting as the audience are more esteemed people who have got the expertise and experience in the respective fields, and who have dedicated their time and energy to come over here as the presenters of different topics, as the moderators, and also as the participants of this seminar, who are capable of proposing solid suggestions and were capable of analyzing this problem in a very detailed manner. So we expect a fruitful and meaningful deliberation in this day. I welcome all the delegates, presenters, moderators, and all the well-wishers and also the students to this gathering. Thank you very much.